Take your books, take your pencils, and start rules. For differentiating vector or vector functions. Vector functions. As we have seen, the derivative of a vector r of t is phi of t times I plus psi of t times g plus he of t times k is by definition equal to r prime of t equals phi prime of t times I plus psi prime of t times g plus he prime of t times k. Once it's straight way follows that the basic rule for differentiating functions hold for vectors as well. Here we shall derive the formulas for differentiating a sum and a scalar product of vectors. The other formulas we shall write down and leave their derivation for the student. The first, the derivative of a sum of vectors is equal to the sum of the derivatives of the vectors. Write down the derivatives of a sum of vector is equal to the sum of the derivatives of the vectors. Indeed, let there be two vector R first of T equals phi first of T times I plus C first of T times G plus he first of T times K and R second of T. It means phi second of T times I plus psi second of T times G plus he second of T times K. Formula 3. Their sum, is R first of T plus R second of T. Or phi first of T plus phi second of T. Phi first plus phi second times I plus psi first of T, this T, plus psi second of T times G plus he first of T plus he second of T times K. By the definition of a derivative of a variable vector, we have D of this sum R first plus R second with respect to T equals phi first of T plus phi second of T prime times I, vector I, orta, plus psi first of T plus psi second of T prime times G plus he first of T plus he second of T prime times K, vector K, equals psi first of T prime times I vector I plus psi first of T prime times vector G plus he first of T prime times vector K, K plus phi second of T prime times vector I plus psi second of t prime times vector g plus he second of t prime times, prime times vector k. On r first prime plus r second prime with respect to t, of course. Hence, d of r first of t plus r second of t with respect to t equals the derivative with respect to t of r first plus the derivative with respect to t of r second. Here 2 second. Формула maybe wrong one. It was the point 1. Now the point 2, the second point. The derivative of a scalar product of vectors is expressed by the formula. Formula I will give you after writing. The derivative of a scalar product of vector of vectors is expressed by the formula derivative of product r first times r second with respect to t equals derivative of the first vector with respect to t times the second vector without derivative, just second vector, clean, plus the first vector without derivative, not derivative, times derivative of second vector with respect to t. Formula from 2. Second formula. Indeed, if r first of t and r second of t are defined by formula 3, by this formula, formula 3, then, as we know, the scalar product of these vectors is equal to r, this scalar product is equal to r first of t times r second of t equals phi first times phi second plus psi first times psi second, here first one, plus he first times he second of t, always of t. For this reason, derivative of product of these two vectors with respect to t equals, I cannot write down of t very long. Without t, I will write down phi first prime times phi second plus phi first times phi second prime plus psi first prime times psi second plus psi first times psi second prime plus he first prime times he second plus he first without prime times he, oh sorry, times he second prime. Phi first prime times phi second plus psi first prime times psi second plus he first prime times he second. I just write down in the first bracket. Plus, and this, this and this, I place into the second bracket. Phi first times phi second, phi second prime, plus psi first times c second prime plus he first times he second prime. Om. Phi first prime I plus c first prime G plus he first prime k. Scalar product with phi second i plus psi second g plus he second k. Psi second g plus he second, it's 2 second k. It is scalar product that equals this bracket, the first bracket, plus into the second bracket. We stay scalar product of two vector phi first psi first And he first. And the second vector, phi second prime, psi second prime, he second prime. Good. Oh, what we have? Look, this vector, it is derivative of the first vector r, r first with respect to t. D r first with respect to t. This vector, it just vector r second, just times r second, plus here, maybe I write down here r first prime, here r second, this r first without prime, just r first, and in this r second prime, r second prime is prime. Plus r first times derivative of r second with respect to t. The theorem is proved. We proved this theorem. From formula RAM 2, this formula, we have the following important corollary. Write down corollary. Corollary. If the vector E is a unit vector, it means its length equals 1. That is, modulus of vector E equals 1. Then its derivative is a vector perpendicular to it. Proof. Let's prove this corollary. If E a unit vector, then E times E equals scalar product or just modulus E squared or 1 squared or 1. Scalar product. Let us take the derivative with respect to C of both sides of the latter equation. E times E equals 1. It means E, the first E, times derivative of the second E with respect to T plus derivative of the first E with respect to T times the second E without derivative equals derivative of 1 of constant 1 with respect to T will be just 0, because derivative of constant always equals 0. Then this and this derivatives equals, because if we rotate our multiplier, we can have equals results, because it we can write down 2e times derivative of vector E with respect to T equals 0. Or if we cancel out 2 in this side and in this side divided by 2, we will have E times derivative of E with respect to T equals 0. It is scalar product. But if scalar product equals 0, scalar product of two vectors, it means these two vectors are perpendicular. And this means that the vector dE with respect to T is perpendicular to the vector E. The corollary proof. The third point. The constant numerical factor may be taken outside the sign of the derivative, and I will write down this formula later. After writing, the constant numerical factor may be taken outside outside the sign of the derivative. D A times R of T over DT equals A times DR of T with respect to T or A times R prime of T. Room 3. Good. Maybe like okay. The fourth. The derivative of a vector product of vectors R first and R second. The derivative of a vector product of vector R first and R second is determined by the formula. Is determined by the formula. Derivative of vector product R first by R second with respect to T equals derivative of the first vector with respect to T vector product with vector R2 plus vector R first vector product with D R second with respect to T. It is formula room 4. Good. Next subtitle. The first and second derivatives of a vector with respect to the arc length, the curvature of a curve, the principal normal. Write down the first and second derivatives of a vector. With respect to the arc length, the curvature of a curve the principal normal the principal normal the arc length of a space curve M0A, this curve, equals S is determined just as in the case of curve in a plane. When a variable point A with the coordinate x, y and z, x, y and this length equals z, moves along a curve, the arc's length S varies. Conversely, when S varies, the coordinates x, y, z of a variable point A lying on the curve also vary. Therefore, the coordinates x, y, and z of a variable point A of the curve may be regarded as function of the arc's length S. X is phi of S, y is psi of S, and z is chi of s. In these parametric equations of the curve, the arc's length s is the parameter. S is the parameter. The vector OA equals R is accordingly expressed as R is phi of S times vector I, order I plus psi of s times vector g and plus chi of s times vector k. On r equals r of s. Formula 1. Thus, the vector r is a function of the r's length s. Let us find out the geometrical meaning of the derivative the r over the s. As is evident from this figure, we have the following equations. M0a equals s. M0a equals s. Arc AB equals delta s. Arc M0 to B s plus delta s. MA plus AB, S plus delta S. Vector OA is R of S. Vector R of S. Vector OB. OB is R of this vector S plus delta S. R of S plus delta S. And vector AB is vector delta R. Vector AB delta R on R of S plus delta S minus R of S. Delta R over delta S will be vector AB over arc length AB. We have already seen that the vector dr over ds, this vector, equals limit as delta S approaches 0, delta R over delta S is in the direction of the tangent to the curve at the point A toward increasing S. On the other hand, we have the equality limit S vector AB over arc length AB equals 1. The limit of the ratio of the chord length, the arc length. Hence, dr over ds is a unit vector. In the direction of the tangent. Let us denote it by sigma. Dr over ds equals vector sigma. If the vector r is represented by the projections, r is here formula 2, maybe r is x times I plus y times g plus z times k, then sigma must be dx over ds times I plus dy over ds times g plus dz over ds times k. Formula 3. And square root of dx over ds squared plus dy over ds squared plus dz over ds squared equals 1 unit vector. Let us now examine the second derivative of the vector functions d double r over ds twice. That is the derivative with respect to dr over ds, and determine the geometric significance. From formula 2 that we write down up, it follows that this second derivative x equals derivative with respect to s of derivative of the vector r with respect to s, or d sigma over ds. Consequently, we have to find limit as delta s approaches zero of delta sigma, vector sigma, over delta s. From this figure, we have AB equals delta S. A B equals delta S. A L, vector A L. A L, this vector, equals sigma. Vector B K. Vector B K, this vector, equals sigma plus delta sigma. Draw from the point B the vector B L first equals sigma, the parallel of the vector AL and with equal length BL first. That equal to sigma. From the triangle B K L first, we find B K equals B L first vector, it's L, L, letter L, plus L first K vector. BK, it is BL first plus L first K. Or sigma plus delta sigma equals sigma plus L first K. Thus, L first K will be equal to delta sigma. Since by what has been proved, the length of the vector sigma does not change. Modulus of sigma must be equal to sigma plus delta sigma. Modulus of sigma plus delta sigma. Hence, the triangle BKL first is an isosceles triangle. The angle delta phi at the vertex of the triangle is the angle, this angle. Is the angle through which the tangent to the curve turns from the point A to the point B. In other words, it corresponds to the increment in the arc length delta S. From the triangle BKL first, BKL first, we find L first. L first K equals modulus of delta sigma or 2 modulus of sigma times modulus of sine delta phi over 2 equals 2 times modulus of sine delta phi over 2. Modulus sigma equal to 1. Divide both sides of the later equation by delta S. By delta S. We have modulus of delta sigma by delta S equals 2 modulus of sine of delta phi over 2 over delta S. Or modulus of sine of delta phi over over 2, sorry, over delta phi over 2 times modulus delta phi over delta S. Let us now pass to the limit on both sides of the later equation as delta S approaches 0. It will be equal to modulus of d sigma over ds, modulus of derivative. Sorry. Then, limit as delta s approaches 0 of modulus of sine of delta phi over 2 over delta phi over 2 equals unit. Since in this case we consider curves such that there exists a limit of delta phi over delta s as delta s approaches 0. And consequently, delta phi approaches 0 as delta s approaches 0. Thus, after passing the limit, we have modulus d sigma over ds equals limit as delta s approaches 0 of modulus of delta phi over delta s. Formula 4. The ratio of the angle of turn delta phi of the tangent when the point A goes to the point B to the length delta S on the arc AB in absolute value is called, just as it is in the case of a plane curve, the average curvature of the given line of the segment AB. The ratio of the angle of turn delta phi of the tangent when the point A goes to the point B the length delta S of the arc AB in absolute value is called just as it is in the case of the plane curve the average curvature of the given line on the segment AB. Average curvature equals modulus of delta pi over delta s. The limit of the average curvature as delta s approaches zero is called the curvature. Curvature of the line at the point A and is denoted by K. K curvature equals limit as delta S approaches zero of delta pi over delta S. But then from formula 4, this formula. It follows that the sigma over the S equals K, which means that the length of the derivative of a
unit vector of a tangent with respect to the arc length is equal to the curvature of the line at the given point. Since the vector sigma is a unit vector, its derivative d sigma over ds is perpendicular to it. Thus, the vector d sigma over ds is equal in length to the curvature of the curve and in direction is perpendicular to the vector of the tangent. Write down definition. The straight line that has the same direction as the vector d sigma over ds and passes through the corresponding point of the curve is called the principal normal. Of the curve at the given point. The principal normal. We denote by vector n the unit vector of the direction. Since the length of the vector d sigma over ds is equal to k which is the curvature of the curve. We have d sigma over ds is k times the unit norm. The reciprocal of the curvature is called the radius of curvature. The radius of curvature of the line at the given point and is denoted by capital R. It means 1 over K equals radius R. So we can write the second derivative of R with respect to S equals d sigma over ds equals n over R. Formula 5. From this formula, it follows that 1 over r squared equals the second derivative of vector r with respect to s squared, formula 6. But this second derivative equals the second derivative of x with respect to s plus the second derivative of y straight derivative with respect to s times g plus the second derivative of z times k. Hence, y over r will be equal to square root of sum of square of these second derivatives. Formula 6 prime. This formula enables us to compute the curvature of a line at any point, provided that this line is represented by parametric equations in which the parameter is the arc length s. In other words, if the radius factor of the variable point of the given line is expressed as a function of the arc length. Let us consider the case when the radius vector r is expressed as a function of an arbitrary parameter t. R equals r of t. Arbitrary parameter t. In this case, the arc's length s will be regarded as a function of the parameter t. Then, the curvature is computed as follows. Dr over dt, it's r, equals dr over ds times ds over dt. Formula 7. Since modulus of dr over ds equals 1, we have dr over dt squared equals ds over dt squared. Formula 8. Differentiating the right and left side of h, we reducing by 2, we get dr over dt, it's r, times the second derivative of vector r over dt double equals ds over dt times the second derivative of the function s over dt twice. Formula 9. Further, from formula 7, this formula, it follows that dr over ds equals dr over dt times 1 over ds over dt. Differentiate with respect to s both sides of this equation, the second derivative of r with respect to s equals the second derivative of r with respect to t times 1 over the second derivative of the derivative of s with respect to t squared minus dr over dt times the ratio in numerators, the d double s over dt twice over ds over dt squared. Substituting into formula 6, this formula, the expression obtained for the second derivative of r with respect to s, we get 1 over r squared equals the second derivative of r with respect to t times 1 over ds over dt squared minus dr over dt times the second derivative of s with respect to t over the derivative squared, all of this squared equals d double r over dt squared times ds over dt squared minus 2 d double r over dt twice times dr over dt times ds over dt times d double s over dt twice plus the derivative of the vector r over dt squared times the second derivative of s over dt squared, and all of this divided by ds over dt to the power of 6. Expressing ds over dt and d double s over dt twice by formulas 8 and 9, these two formulas. In terms of the derivatives of r of t, we get 1 over r squared equals ratio in numerator the second derivative of r squared times the first derivative of r squared minus the second derivative of r times the first derivative of r scalar product squared over the first derivative of r squared, and all of this with power 3. Formula 10. Formula 10 may be rewritten as follows: k squared of equals 1 over r squared equals ratio in numerator we stay the vector product of the first derivative of t and second derivative of r with respect to t squared, and in denominator we stay dr over dt squared and in the power 3. Formula 11. We have obtained a formula that enables us to calculate the curvature of a given line at any point for an arbitrary parametric representation of this curve. If in a particular case the curve is a plane curve and lies in the xy plane, that its parametric equation have the form x is phi of t, y is psi of t, and z is 0. Putting these expressions of x, y, z into formula 11, we get the Euler derivative formula that yields the curvature of a plane curve presented parametrically. It means k is modulus of phi prime of t times c to prime of t minus c prime of t times phi to prime of t over phi prime squared plus c prime squared to the power of 3 over 2. For example, compute the curvature of the helix. R is I times A cosine of T plus G times A sine of T plus K times A and T helix at an arbitrary point. Solution. Dr over dt equals minus I times A sine of t plus G times A cosine of t plus K AM. The second derivative minus I times A cosine of t minus G times A sine of t. The vector product, the first derivative and the second derivative. It is determinant. The first line I, G, K. The second line minus A sine of T here. A cosine of T here. And KAM, it is AM. Here minus A cosine of T, minus A sine of T, and zero. Calculate, determinate, we have I times A squared M sine of T minus G times A squared M cosine of T plus K A squared. It means the vector product of these two derivatives squared equals a to the power of 4 times m squared plus 1. The derivative squared, the first derivative squared, equals a squared sine squared of t plus a squared times cosine squared of t plus a squared m squared or a squared times 1 plus m squared. Consequently, 1 over r squared equals a to the power 4 times m squared plus 1 over a to the power 2 times 1 plus m squared cubed equals 1 over a squared times 1 plus m squared squared. Whence r is a times 1 plus m squared, or constant. Thus, the helix has a constant radius of curvature. Note that if a curve lies in a plane, then without violating generality, we can assume that it lies in the xy plane. This can always be achieved by transforming the coordinates. Now, if the curve lies in the xy plane, then z is zero, but then the second derivative of that of z is zero too. Also, and consequently, the vector n likewise lies in the xy plane. We thus conclude that if a curve lies in a plane, then its principal normal lies in the same plane. In this moment, we can end our lecturing.